for a superior place to eat? Well, come on down to Boulevard Shop, right on Reseda, where we have a delicacy of different Asian cuisine to try out. We'll take you on a very quick tour of what's to eat here for your pleasure. We start with Kogiya, Korean barbecue at its finest. As you can tell from the dope picture of a cow as a logo. And we see two of our associates walking out who just enjoyed some Kogiya. How was it?
Yum, delicious. The food smelled bomb.
Awesome.
Yeah. Yes.
Go there for your Korean barbecue pleasure. And close by, we'll take you on. Look at this unexpected find. I mean, you can get soft serve many places. Can you get soft cream? I mean, look at this place. It has a couch. That couch is cool. Two of our wonderful associates are walking in. They have a really nice, pretty ice cream logo. Man, soft cream. The place to go.
I think I'm beauty. I'm gonna walk by soft cream and then ignore it. Mm-mm. Pineapple, strawberry.
Pineapple choice, yeah.
And a non-dairy choice.
What?
Soft cream is where it's at. Go, check it out. Yeah, how's yours?
Really good.
Really cool. Delicious. All right, also on the list is Katsuya. It looks delicious. We can see a chef working hard in there, but they're closed currently. So come here in business hour time. Yelp has given Uba Tuba Acai. There's a turtle, so you know on the logo, so you know this place is gonna be delicious. Check it out, Uba Tuba. And
you can order online.
You can order online. We'll keep our journey going. Ah, now if you're in the mood for some pho, order with Bon Bon. What? I almost missed Bon Bon. Some tea place as well, so if you're in the mood for some really good tea, sorry gentlemen, Bon Bon is where it would be at. Also highly recommended. Then we'll move on to Pho 22. And at the very end, there is Chinese cuisine. And it looks like a wonderfully nice place. Yelp reviews have it high. And there you go, here at Superior Boulevard Shopping, you have an assorted view of different Asian spots to eat at that all look delightful. But most importantly, this spot has a discovery that none of us ever realized. So, okay, moving on.
Luxury homes, luxury food.
We start off our tour of kickin' Cajun. Asian Cajun seafood. I've never seen anything like it. My God, that sounds delicious. I would definitely give this a shot. What, you get plastic bibs? I mean, come on, you know it's authentic Cajun if there's bibs. And we'll continue going around. Bounce Boba Lounge? That's not even a cafe, it's a lounge. Like, that's next level boba. I mean, you can see there's bananas hanging out on the top. They have sandwiches. We're gonna have a quick interview to talk more about it. Japan.
It's grown a lot over the years, lots of remodeling inside. They have awesome paninis. They turn their paninis into rice bowls for those of you who are more into rice bowls. Great boba drinks, lots of different options for the drinks, not just boba. And yeah, come by, it's really delicious.
Awesome. Well, that's you have my vote. I'll be checking that. I'll check out the lounge pretty soon. And along our journey, we have authentic Japanese. You know it's authentic because it says it. And so, but a small island, a island.
And if I go, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who's going old with you. But I wanna walk 500 miles and I wanna walk 500 more just to be the man who walks 1,000.
So you just left CSUN, you're walking down Plummer, not too far from the College of Edinburgh. Where do you go? Nice little shopping center over here. Now, in case you've never been here, there's a few really local good spots. Number one, there is going to be coming up Sweet Snow Snow Cream. After our Sweet Cream adventure, I don't think they're going to compare, but that's okay. Give it a shot. You never know. Maybe I'm wrong. I'm open to that. Next to that, we have the old Potato Factory. Now, the Potato Factory, if you like potatoes, which I do, is fantastic. French fries, baked potato, Potato O'Brien, probably, I hope so. Potato Factory. But the place in question, the number one spot, which I'm gonna zero in on, is Bun Mi. Wow. Bun Mi is fantastic. It's Vietnamese sandwiches and more. And when they mean more, I mean pho. I mean chicken, I mean beef, rice. It is just, this got me through college. Bun Mi, you gotta check it out for Vietnamese food. Right after that, Pizza Rev. I mean, it's good pizza. You can't go wrong with really good pizza. They even have, check out Waffle Love. High Yelp reviews, and there's waffles. I think there's one thing that all of us should agree on, is that pancakes are nowhere as good as waffles. There's no question. And there's a Dunkin' Donuts, but there's waffles. Just like the pioneers in the Wild West, venture out today to Prairie Street, where you're gonna find an assortment of food from all different types of culture. We start our journey today galloping to A&W Seafood. My goodness, that is some classic seafood. Boom. We have a sushi and a teriyaki spot, which I've actually eaten at before. It's quite delicious. Next to. But check this place out. Poseidon, the Greek god of the ocean, here at CSUN, right next to the College of Education, kind of. A lounge and restaurant. Another place to go for some wonderful Mediterranean food. Absolutely. Poseidon. I mean, the light blink, they turn from blue to green to yellow, probably. My goodness. And then, of course, there's a falafel palace across the street, the Mandarin Deli. I mean, just whatever you're in the mood for, if it's Mediterranean or Asian, it's here. It's fantastic. In this Prairie Shopping Center, there may be a live scan, there may be a sugar fix down at the end, there's some Szechuan Chinese, but a local favorite is Emily's since 1955. Tell us about Emily's.
Okay, it's the voted best breakfast and it is hands down. It's family owned and they have some cultural dishes, breakfast dishes from Lebanon, since that's where the family came from. But you should definitely try it. And I believe they give CSUN students a discount with their ID.
That sounds like an amazing deal to me. That's wonderful. Check out Emily's
Yella,
as they would say. Hurry up, guys. We're moving on.
Put on my blue suede shoes and I
car wash by day, but when the night falls, the sun sets pretty soon, this place will become pop-up chicken, Nashville-type chicken. Secret to locals only. Not every place can be unique and individualistic. Sometimes you need places like The Habit for some solid burgers. Chipotle. I mean, my goodness, it's Chipotle. And if you want your chopping to stop, go down to the salad shop, Chop Stop. More than a salad.
Singer Soul, right there in the corner with the sunglasses.
What?
Right there, really good Mexican.
Oh, that's really cool. All right, so there's some great Mexican restaurants, right? There is everything. And then, I mean, sometimes at the end of the day, it's just a good old fashioned Chili's. University Plaza, probably the most famous location since it's on Nordhoff and it's extremely close to school. Now, maybe you've driven past it, you haven't seen all the sights. Yes, there's a Panda Express, there's a Waba Grill, but also at the top there's a ramen place, which are pretty hard to find, a boba place, and it even has an arrow pointing upstairs. And coming soon, my goodness, Lumberjack Axe Throwing. Take out some of your stress the good old-fashioned way, Lumberjack. And as we go through, there's a classic Yoshinoya and a California Chicken Cafe. In fact, tell us about California Chicken Cafe.
It's really good. Try their, Chinese chicken salad. It has pasta in it.
Fishbowl Poke Cafe, or Poke Company. My bad, not cafe. Apparently they make burritos with
Poke burritos with Cheetos or hot Cheetos?
With hot Cheetos. Group, let's get a shot of your reaction to hot Cheetos. All right, wonderful. Poke Bowl. I think everyone should try that place out.
Imagine.
If you decide to exit a little past Nordhoff, you'll come to this wonderful little shopping center. You'll notice it's right next to the 99 cents outlet. And on there you have, for start, the Urban Cafe. The Urban Cafe, delicious, is in the details, so you know they're being detailed with all of their work. Then, right next to that, there's a drive-through Starbucks, so if you're in a rush, drive-through Starbucks is the way to go. There's a flame broiler, Enough said. We're gonna move on to Farm Boys Burgers. Now, this is the place that has me the most intrigued because Farmer Boys, I mean, it sounds like it's good old fashioned, just beef burgers and breakfast and briskets and I don't know. I'm gonna tell you this. I can't tell you how the place is. I've never eaten here. I didn't know it existed until this video. And now I will be trying this place out at my next available opportunity. Caesars right next to it. And if we continue down to, Little Caesars is classic. You can get an entire pizza on your own, just chow down. But if you ever just wanted that kind of style of pizza, it's there. There's a Frusion place. Fruit and ice cream kind of blend. Frusion. Got crepes, waffles, gelato. Waffles, guys. Our real journey ends here at Seoul Restaurante Mexicano. And we are excited to try some food out. We'll give you guys a review once we're done. We'll take some pictures, but try somewhere new and unique.
Ay, 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 mi amor, ay, mi morena de mi corazón.